Hi, everybody. I'd like to talk about the butterfly valves today. The butterfly valves are the control mechanism that prevents propellant from flowing into the engine until you really want it in the engine. They're located between the engine and the fuel tanks on the missile. And you can see right here on our engine display outside exactly where they're located. Now, there are four of these things. We only have a couple of them on the engine. The other two, one of them actually got cut in half to use as a display in a control center. And the other one is right here in my lap. So let's take a look at that and we can see how they work. These are pretty ingenious devices, really, for just being a valve. So the valves have to be leak-proof. The valves can never, ever leak. And so you don't have any O-rings or gaskets in these valves. How it works is there's a metal disc right in here, and that metal disc completely seals the valve from one side to the other. So there's no gasket or O-ring or anything in here. It's a metal disc that completely seals the dry side from the wet side of the valve. This would be the wet side of the valve. So normally there would be propellant. In this case, what is this? Fuel. In this case, fuel would be sitting right up against this. It's called a shear disc, is what this disc is called. It's called a shear disc, and we'll talk about why in just a minute. Let me turn the valve over, and you can see the other side. And so on the other side is what's called the actual butterflies, why we call them butterfly valves. And the butterfly itself is this disc right here, and this little wing. This is kind of, I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's kind of a little wing shape in there. And we'll talk about the function of that in a few minutes. So what happens in this, you can see there's a shaft right here that the butterfly rotates on. And what happens is when you open the valve, that shaft turns, and the butterfly, this piece here, actually shears its way through the metal disc. So it cuts it open kind of like a can opener almost, and permits then the propellant to flow. Okay, a couple other features of the valve is that it's useful to know when it's installed on the missile, it's useful to know what's going on both sides of the valve. And so you can actually sample what's the atmosphere, if you will, on both sides of the valve. On the dry side, this is the dry side of the valve, we can attach what's called a sniffer to this port right here. And it's just a hose that goes to a piece of equipment that will allow us to sniff the air on the dry side of the valve and look for vapors from propellant. If we detect any vapors down there, then obviously something's leaking, so the valve would need to be pulled out and repaired. Now on the wet side of the valve, which is this side, we have an umbilical port right here, this thing right here. And we can actually unscrew this and connect a hose to there and bleed off a little of the propellant that's on this side of the valve. We can check it for probably purity is what we're looking for, make sure it's actually okay. What else? We need to make sure that we know that the valve is open. You know, what's the status of the valve, open or closed? This is really important when you go to launch the missile. So this right here is a position sensor. And you pull this little red cap. This is a protective cap. I'm not sure I can get it off of here. There we go. And there are just wires inside, and there would be a little plug and socket connector thing here that would connect to some umbilical cables. And these are the cables that run all the way from the missile back to the control center to provide feedback on whether the valve is open or not. And so very important to know the status of the valve. What else? Oh, so how do you open the valve? Well, the valve is opened pyrotechnically. And it's opened by an explosive charge in this little gas generator right here. There would be wires connected to these. These are called squibs, and we'll see these in a diagram I have for you in a minute. There are two of them. In case one of them fails, it's redundant, so it'll still go. So what happens is the explosive charges detonate inside here, and it creates a pulse of high-pressure gas that actually opens the valve. And the best way to see that is to take a look at a diagram, and we can see exactly how this works. So this diagram from the technical orders shows really clearly how the valve operates. So the shear disc that we talked about is this little piece that runs right along here. And the butterfly sits directly below that. In fact, it's attached to the shear disc by a locking ring. It goes all the way around. And then this, of course, is the wing assembly that we saw in the valve. The gas generator is right here. Dual squibs. What that means is there are, you know what a squib is? A squib is just a little explosive charge. So in this case, there's two of them. In case one of them doesn't work, then, you know, it's redundant, right? So the gas created by that explosive charge flows into this little chamber and then up this little area right here into the cylinder. And there's a piston right here. And the gas pressure then pushes that piston to the left in this diagram anyway. And the piston is connected to the locking pin by a little armature. And so what happens, and this is the key part of this, because of the shape of the locking pin like this, and because of the shape of the notch in the butterfly that the locking pin fits into, that when the locking pin gets pulled back this way, because of the shape of that whole thing, the butterfly gets pushed down. Once that happens, then the shear disc breaks, and then oxidizer begins to flow in, and the sheer pressure of the oxidizer flowing in then forces the butterfly all the way into the open position, and then the wing keeps the whole thing from flapping, as we talked about. And here's the sniffer port. We mentioned that as well right here. And again, all that is for is so that you can, for inspection purposes, you can connect a little sensor here and then sample the air inside this on the dry side of the valve and see if there's any propellant vapors there. And if there are, then it means that something's leaking. And of course, then you have to go in and take the valve out and do whatever repairs are required. I've made this diagram into a really nice animation that shows exactly how the valve works. So let's take a look at it. The shear disc is shown here in blue. Here's the actual butterfly, and the wing assembly is right here. Here is the locking pin and the piston here shown in yellow, and the squibs in red right here. When the squibs fire, the high pressure gas forms here, runs through a little tube up into the cylinder, pushes the piston to the left, pulls the locking pin with it, and the valve opens. Just that simple. All right, so more than you ever wanted to know about the butterfly valves, there'll be a quiz. Thanks for watching.